Terry Bogard versus Energy Stone and the Pokemon Trainer. Yeah, we're saying Energy Stone now. I'll fix it to Energy Steam. It is. Energy Steam. And Steam is out here. Getting the small creature. At the moment, we're just seeing a lot of Terry Bogard ledge traffic, which just seems to be where Sunga signs the most. But already, from the start of SD, not calculating correctly, the read of Wine Whip making him SD towards the Blast Zone. That is a calculation you don't want to fail that often. Now adding a lot of pressure to the platforms, making it seem like there's not much room to read from. Okay, so a lot of high recoveries coming from this game. Seeing some chases with the downs and grab, but not able to advantage for anything. Seems like that at the moment, Sungus is abusing the fact that he has the lead, and he's playing, I wouldn't say a slow aggressive playstyle, but a playstyle good enough for him to just add damage by singular hits than big combo strings, as all he needs is just to extend the lead. And he does get more from it than Squirtle, as Terry's damage output is way better. He's the Ivysaur though, landing down there to cover himself, and now we've to some space again, some zoning game. No down to up here at that percentage, baby. But you know what there is here at this percentage? We got Go, Buster Wolf, Power Gazer. Both options now that the Energy Steam has to watch out for. Okay, we got the Power Gazer on stage. Not gonna punish anything, and he goes for the great Terry jabs. Missing everything. Stone needs something to take get rid of the stock because they're the same percentage, but he's a whole stock behind. Oh, and the dash attack, or power attack, this is called in zone games. Take it. But the respawn to Ivysaur, taking another stock right back. Oh, here we go, Squirtle setups. Oh, actually does not get to continue it, and now has to find a way to get back to Squirtle's Crumbles, which he does right now. 60%, and I think we'll get rid of Squirtle soon, I do not know. Maybe he's deciding to stay with it. Oh, that could have been dangerous. Terry Snare might be small, but it has dangerous combo potential out of this world. Alright, the ledge trapping just keeps going on. It's not that he's putting that much pressure with moves, but just his presence at the ledge is pretty much... He's putting the work onto this man. He acts there's no option on the ledge. He's actually being held back. Held back towards the wall. He's the grab. He's gonna pummel that little green the cabbage thing. I actually don't know what animal Ivysaur is. Is it a dog? Is it something? I don't know. Gets fortune. It's a son. Gets thrown again off stage. But Ivysaur with the hugest hitbox. Like, that down is the size of the freaking Polar Galaxy. And the biggest anti-air. Like, there's no bigger dick energy than a Power Gazer to say, yeah, it's about... this. There. And taking the first game in this song is where's Terry Bogard? That anti is humongous, like. It's not even fair. It's not even fair. With that kill power and that reach, and let's not forget it has some rage to it as well, that is not okay. He asks, are you okay? No, that's not okay. You're not okay, Terry. That's not okay. That thing is not okay. And the worst thing is, it can beat out some stuff. Like, it's not like some Bayo smash attack where it clanks with everything, it beats stuff. But that's okay. Yeah, it's minus 3-4 on shield, but it's like... Alright, so here we go again. We're going on to Pokemon Stadium, seeing if this will give Energy Steam some homestead advantage. At the moment, you're just seeing Song is playing with his old playstyle. He's saying, if I don't have to go in, I won't. But when I do get in, there's gonna be some damage, baby. Ooh. But Energy Steam doing the exact same thing all the time, putting a lot of combos. He's grabbing out the dancers, putting a lot of strings, rising tackle, and it's dead even already. Oh, can't stop that move. That will keep moving. All you can do to that is just hope you hit it hard enough to something happen. Or you can just jump on it. Or being called up the air dodge. Or maybe just pressing him to mass air dodge and getting him the force mass. Which is actually pretty damn powerful. It's just very laggy. I back to obviously off stage. Not gonna get anything out of it. As he seems to trade once more. And that's a very sad part of Terry. He actually doesn't have that many options to deal with tanking at all. So a lot of players just decide to hang at the ledge a little bit when they have to fight Terry. Very smart. By Energy Stone to decide to do the exact same thing and just stay at the ledge. Because Energy Steam is pretty much safer. Oh, but here's the jab, jab. Are you okay? Bash the wolf. That is actually not even a thing. If you, well, I shouldn't push that. But that's not a true thing unless you down to first. But it seems very true. It's kind of like a some kin setup, with, so you can put like it feels so true. Ooh, I actually thought it was just gonna be a nair up tilt power gaze up for that. And here's the thing, if you don't have any air drift and you're gonna land against Ivysaur, it's gonna be a hard battle. Oh, and the edge guard! I love that from Energy Stain, he actually goes all the way out there. He actually wants an edge guard. He's not afraid of going down for 5, which is exactly what you need to do on Ultimate, especially with a character like Ivysaur. Okay, I'm starting something with Ivysaur. I was just okay, not being that future creative. Power tackle coming in once more. Ooh, and the force was gonna reach from there. Oh, and flare blitz? Hello? Oh, and he SD's custom. That kinda sucks. And you can tell. I can tell that from him that I'm not happy about that. Okay. So going to a game 3! But where are we heading? We're heading to final destination. Start battle. Parry. Young Link. And we're gonna see Young Link from Energy Steam. I haven't seen this Young Link before. Is it good? And a Geese Steam. It's a mix! Okay. Alright, now. The FD with the Young Link. Now that's gonna be a lot of combo setups. And a sword. I mean, it's a very small sword that is almost the same range as some people are just hands. But hey, a sword is a sword. Nah, that's a needle. Yeah, it means Messina has a butter knife. That's a butter knife. Okay. Anyway, Terry with a fast lead with that boss. That move is actually so strong. Wonder what any Geestein has planned for to deal with this. I think he had the mindset of, you know, camming out these fighting game characters as they are not used to this absurd amount of spacing that they are on platform fighters. But students seem to always. It's not just. Seems to always have figured that out. I don't know why my brain just kind of. So, stuck lead. It's no longer for anyone. Even game. When it comes to stuck. But Terry. Such a menace. His character. And even though he's only been out for like a few weeks, he's still showing up big time. Oh, nice. Butt dodge kicks and grab. Okay, so all of the protectors are coming out right now. I feel like Terry's good. Terry's definitely a good character. You can't give a character comeback vector and not have them be at least above decent. Like, look at Lucario. He might not be at this problem, but he's way above decent. And to think that he has the biggest anti-air in the game and he has a command grab is thing, looks a lot like Isabelle's. That gotta be good. But you know what is not good for Terry? Being behind against Young Link, because now you are forced to approach this projectile spamming kid. But it's okay if you just power dunk him out of the stage. Okay, down throw on the up B is just a bit of fun. It's good damage. It's very good damage. Okay, here we go. You can see a lot of projectiles controlling the zone again. Just to add pressure to whenever someone gets tried to get anywhere near. Oh, actually beefy up B said he doesn't have to deal with the up tilts by Chungus. And he's staying at the ledge. Hello, hello. Oh, we got the go meter on as well. This could be it. Oh, but he misses. Well, this misses, but he misses the setup for it. And now he gets up smash. Not as strong as the other links, but he tries again. Oh, too early. Okay, we got the back throw. Now, very close to the session. I wonder what he's gonna go for. Oh, he went for the power geyser. And that's it. No, he's not gonna make it back. And that's the Gimp. And a key stain taking a game. Making this a game 4 now. Seems like the Young Link actually worked out. Way more projectiles, way more patience, some gimping, and here we are in game 4 instead of a clean 2-0 by Zangief. Are we going on Yoshi's?
Yeah. Pokemon trainer.
Oh, and we're going back to the Pokemon trainer. I gotta be honest, I do not understand this. It actually seemed like the Young Link did professionally work, but you're gonna trust in energy and instincts, decisions, and let's see what you can do. Here we are on Yoshi's Story. You do not know the song, but it's gonna act like it's going do 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 Yoshi do 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 do. Exactly, thank you so much for back on. Alright, so what we see here is the Ivysaur coming in. Why that's such a scroll change? It's gonna do some damage, but just gonna keep control the zone way better. It's gonna not do that much success with that as Zangief does power attack with through the entire zoning. Zangief really wanna just come back to the habit of you can say it. That trapping, and he's successfully getting two done and getting a kill off with it with that burning one. Being a super good move. I'm not done. Well, I thought he was gonna do ladder combo, something like some Mario stuff. Anyway, last dodge. Hey, never mind. I mean, also, let's go there. But it's the last dodge. When the Geese team, it might be his manage break is stuck. Loses break, the tournament break is stuck in general. He does not figure anything out right now. Spike back in general. I sent some to this and winners. And there's the go. Out of condition and no longer there. So, we are seeing. Anyway, so now we have a situation that can actually be a combat for any Geese team. Just place this correctly. Wasn't that happy with the counterpick state that he started, but he might end up using this first advantage anyway. Ooh, Ivysaur catching that landing. He might have something to work with. Just... Is it over? And it's... Oh! Salem! Nah, I'm just playing. There's still a lot of ledge chopping he has to get through, but he's playing through the ledge chopping of Zangief. Way better than normal. Look at the neutral game. How the bro like stepped twice backwards to start back then. Like in sync of what they want to do. But since there's so much in sync, there's no one to do it. And he jabs the ledge. Oh, he read it. He waited for it. He pressured it and waited afterwards to get the power dunk. And then he goes, okay. And Zangief moves on to grand finals from the loser's side.